The question I have is, do you consider Tertullian one of the church fathers?
Tertullian is another case where it looks like he doesn't meet the classical definition of a father, and therefore would be considered an ecclesiastical writer. Although you will find some people referring to him as a father. So he's kind of a debated case. He doesn't have at least one and really two of the criteria that are needed for being a father. He does have antiquity. He was living in the right age. But in terms of orthodoxy, that's something he possessed at one phase of his career. He was when he was a Catholic, but he then left the Catholic Church and joined another sect called the Montanists that harbored some ideas that are not orthodox. He also consequently is not a saint. Because he unfortunately died out of communion with the church, and therefore the church doesn't regard him as a saint, and consequently he doesn't have approval as in the same way that other fathers do. And so I would personally put him, like Origen, in the category of an ecclesiastical writer. And unfortunately, whereas Origen has undergone something of a rehabilitation, we mentioned earlier, you know, Pope Benedict XVI thinks very highly of him and referred to him as a master of faith and someone worth learning from. Tertullian, because of the fact that his trajectory was away from the unity of the church and away from sound doctrine, he has not experienced that kind of rehabilitation. And so it's a sad case, but he was a very learned author and a valuable author to help us understand the beliefs of Christians and related groups in his own time.
Hope that's a help, Jim.
Well, I think I remember actually reading some of John Paul II's words where he actually did quote Tertullian in certain areas.
Oh, sure. Mm-hmm. He gets quoted, and he gets quoted regularly because he's such a valuable witness to his own time period. But in terms of is he a father, the standard opinion among patristic scholars, I gather, would be no, he doesn't meet the criteria, and so he would be what we call an ecclesiastical writer rather than a father.
Appreciate your call, Jim, and I mean this sincerely. Stay safe in Milpitas.
Okay, thanks. Bye.
All right, bye-bye. 32 after the hour, the toll-free number to reach Jimmy Akin with your questions about the Church Fathers is 1-888-318-7884. Everything you always wanted to know about the Church Fathers, if it had no one to ask, well, now you do. Jimmy Akin, 1-888-31-TRUTH. We'd love to hear from you. These are the great thinkers and saintly figures of the early church. Some of them were proteges of the apostles, and they wrote for hundreds of years. How many do you cover in the book, The Fathers Know Best? About 100?
About 100, yeah. Okay. I have little mini-biographies of all of them, as well as a series of maps to show you where they lived, because you often hear about fathers like, you know, Theodore of Mopsuestia, and you're going, where is Mopsuestia? Well, I've got a map to show you.
Yeah, it's near Hemet, California.
All right. Actually, it's in Turkey.
Okay.